gear. I think. Right now I'm rocking the SSA. SAA, sorry, Single Action Army.
You stole my gun.
They didn't approve my M1911. If I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Yeah, that's true. We don't want that.
No, we don't.
Yeah.
The fifth element. No, I'm sorry. Fifth element was different.
Snow White and the Huntsman.
Oh! I haven't seen that movie yet, but I'm going to have to see it now.
It's pretty good. Oh. This is my favorite character in it, just because I like the way it all flowed.
I actually liked how people could pull it off. They like did it well. I like how a lot of people create their own costumes. And the props, a lot of them are really amazing. Like, they just make it all of cardboard boxes. You don't know how much work they need to do.
How did you come to get the Deadpool?
Big fan of Deadpool, and I'm sort of a jackass anyway, so it just lets me be a complete ass to people and get away with it. So.
Hello again, we're at TNT.
This is Sarah, you pass?
Yep.
Please, what are your costumes?
I am Lady Loki.
And I am Lady Thor.
So, I have to ask, what is cosplay to you? What does it mean to you?
It means working very hard, long hours making things that I like to wear.
Mainly for her, because she mainly does all the sewing. I don't really sew. So she has a great idea. Like, hey, let's dress up like this. And I'm like, okay, make my costume.
I take two pieces of plywood and I glued them together. And then I cut this out and I did wood filler all over. So they give it like a fill to it, like a smooth. And I painted it, and that took hours. And 27 rolls of tape.
Give us your pose.
My pose?
I see your pose.
Okay. Ah, look!
Be careful when you cut it down.
Oh yeah. What is cosplay to you? You know, is it a culture, or is it just something to do to con? So it's the joy you get from the rest of the cosplayers, huh?
Sorry.
He's showing off and looking pretty.
I couldn't resist.
You do look prettier than me.
With Ariel and Caroline.
Hi.
If you would tell us about your costumes, what you are.
We're both doing costumes in the steampunk style and neo-Victorian style. Mine's inspired by my love of the author H.P. Lovecraft, who wrote, I believe it was in the 1920s. He was kind of one of the forefathers of horror in literature. And I don't know, I just really love his work. And we're both former clothing designers.
People who do not cosplay, they have peculiar myths and stereotypes about cosplay. How would you explain, someone who's never cosplayed before, how would you explain what it is and the culture and what it's about?
Well, to explain to somebody who's never cosplayed, the best way to explain it to them is either talk to them, like go to the con and show them what it's like to cosplay. And just show them how many people cosplay as different stuff like anime, video games, steampunk, just other Star Wars stuff and Marvel, and just see from there and just show them what it is. It's not bad, it's not evil. And you know, there's some cosplayers that you're wondering why are they doing this, but other than that, it's all good and fun.
All the under stuff is latex. It's actually done by a person named Lorinda. She'll actually be here later on today. She actually is trying to get a small business going, so.
And they are the judges for this year. Give a round of applause for Mythos Creations, ladies and gentlemen.
Now, I appreciate the fact that you have such great generosity in giving some applause, but I want to tell you something. The people that are coming out here right now, about half of them have never been on a stage before. So what I need you to do is I want a little practice run right here. I want you to show them the love that you would want if you were, getting over the stage fright to do exactly what they're about to do. So let me hear you, ladies and gentlemen. What kind of love would you like to hear?